Welcome to Java forum. Now we are going to see how to install Docker community on Ubuntu 16.04 long term support edition manually. So here you can see that I already downloaded this 3 dbn packages from Docker website. So these 3 dbn packages are specifically for Ubuntu 16.04 long term support edition. So now I have opened the terminal. So I am switching as a root user. After switching as a root user, I am going to install these 3 packages manually. So I am going to install this packages using the command dpkg space -i and the package names. So this is the command. Yes, Docker community edition installation on Ubuntu 16.04 long term support edition is successful. So we are successfully installed the Docker manually. So now I am going to check whether Docker services started or not. So this is the command systemctl status docker.service. So this will print whether Docker is active or not. So you can see that the Docker is started. So most of the time after the installation, Docker service will start automatically. No need to start the Docker manually. So next I am going to run the command docker pull hello world. So this docker pull hello world will download the Docker image called hello world from the Docker repository. So make sure that you have internet connection to run this command. So the image called hello world is downloaded successfully. So now I am going to execute the command docker run hello world. So this docker run hello world will print the welcome message, which is from the image called hello world. So this command used to verify whether docker is installed successfully or not. So docker is installed successfully. So docker space ps will give the list of Docker process running in this machine. Next, I am trying to create one group called Docker. So this Docker group by default it will be created. So no need to create the group called Docker. Next, I am going to add the 2 users which is already existing in this machine to Docker group. So I am adding this user Ramanathan and Java user to the Docker group. So these 2 users will manage the Docker process, and Docker containers will be managed by these 2 users in this machine. So next I am executing setfacl command. So setfacl command used to modify the access control list. So I am giving the permission to the Docker sockets for these 2 users using setfacl command, so that these 2 users can control the Docker sockets. So this Docker socket is a Unix socket. So make sure that only trusted users are added to this ACL list to manage the Docker sockets. Otherwise, all users will pull the images and delete the images. So only trusted user should be added to the Docker group and FACL list. So now I am logging as a Java user. So I am going to execute the Docker commands. So let me check I can able to run or not. So docker run hello world. So I can able to run. Next, I am checking the status of the Docker. So yes, I can able to check the Docker service status.